How do you defeat a godlike character? Do you defeat him with absolute strength? Maybe absolute knowledge? Or do you simply have to be a god yourself? The five war potentials, or the special powers or special war powers depending on what you're familiar with, was a concept brought to us within the start of the Thousand Year Blood War arc of Bleach. It was mentioned to us briefly for the first time within Yamamoto and Yuwashi's confrontation, where Yuwashi disrespects Yamamoto's defeated body, explaining to him that the reason he wasn't considered to be part of the war potentials was due to his ignorance in involving Orihime, or better yet, a human to heal his arm, to which he had lost within the Aizen War. Yuwashi then goes to specify these five individuals capable of turning the advantage of the battle of which the Quincy King had started. These five special threats consisted of, well, depending on the translations that you had read, Ichigo Kurosaki for his latent ability or potential, Kenpachi Zaraki for his combat strength, Ichibei Hiyotsube for his wisdom or knowledge, Sosuke Aizen for his spiritual pressure, and last but not least, Kisuke Urahara for his unknown means or incalculable tricks. In this video, we will be talking about why these characters were considered to be a war potential, and why Yuwashi took caution around them, if they lived up to the expectation, and in what context could they be an issue to the war if the table were in fact to turn in their favour. But hey, before we get started with this list, this video has been sponsored by the great people over at Keeps. If you didn't know, 2-3 guys will experience some sort of male pattern baldness by the time that they get to age 35. Let's be honest, we all know that family member or that friend that you may not want for yourself. Thankfully, you don't have to sit idly by, and you can take action to prevent this. Keep, of course, helps you stop hair loss before it is in fact too late. This is helped by their scientific and affordable approach. These treatments are at least up to 90% effective at reducing and stopping further hair loss, and prevention is definitely the key here. The great thing here is that Keep offers generic versions of the only two FDA approved hair loss products out there. You may have tried them before, but probably never at this price. So hey, if you're ready to take some action, head on down to keeps.com/james to get 50%. Yes, I said 50% off your first order of Keep's hair loss treatment, or if you don't want to manually do it, it's in the description down below for you to click and take you straight there. And if you're still on the fence, there's way more information on the Keep's website as well if you want to go check them out and get yourselves informed. But with that being said, thank you to Keep's for again sponsoring today's video. Right off the bat is our main character, Ichigo Kurosaki. Yes, it's pretty obvious because guess what? He is the main character. Ichigo's potential alone warrants his special war power caution. The potential here refers not only to Ichigo's latent abilities, but also his rapid growth rate. Ichigo never really learnt how to fight, that you could argue. In fact, Ichigo, to me, has only learnt how to survive and achieve power when it comes to training with Urahara for awakening his Shikai, and training with Yoruichi to achieve his Bankai, to then the training with Shinji to subdue his hollow counterpart. Ichigo's fighting ability is always being set on quick thinking and adaptability, best demonstrated for achieving Bankai in just 2.5 days, a feat requiring at least 10 years of practice for other Shinigami. Even though that this is debatable as it isn't technically his Bankai, but if you've read the series, you know, right? You know. Growth rate and potential also apply to Ichigo's combat sense, as he is quickly able to adapt to enemy attack patterns and think up strategies. Naturally, he's able to do this due to unconsciously using Blue Vein to tank damage. These qualities make Ichigo a wild card in the eyes of the Quincy, as time and time again he proves his ability to rise up to the occasion and defy the odds, or quite possibly, fate itself. Ichigo plays a pivotal role in the war itself. He saves Kenpachi Zaraki from a group of Pastonria ambushing him, essentially preserving one of Soul Society's greatest assets, and most importantly, ends up defeating Yuwashi. Without being told, Ichigo deduces and capitalizes on Aizen's plan to deceive Yuwashi using Kyoku Sugetsu, and after Uryu Ishida shoots Yuwashi with a silver arrowhead, Ichigo evolves once again as his Zangetsu reveals a second blade right as Yuwashi destroys the first, allowing him to deal the decisive blow that saves essentially the world. Ichigo's embodiment throughout the majority of the series, being Instinct, was Ichigo's greatest weapon, and one Yuwashi was extremely curious about, while at the same time be most fearful of. It comes to no surprise Kenpachi Zaraki was deemed a special war power due to his immense combat strength. Zaraki is the 11th Kenpachi, a title reserved for the, keyword, strongest Shinigami of the Gotei 13, a title earned by killing the Kenpachi before them. A testament to his dual status as Kenpachi and a special war power is in fact that he earned these distinctions before learning the name of his Zanpakuto, achieving Shikai and then Bankai. To add on to the validity of the title Kenpachi, Zaraki not only defeated the 10th Kenpachi, but as a child, defeated the first Kenpachi Yachiru Unohana as well. That being said, it was because of Unohana that Zaraki starts limiting his true power, even though he was already kind of doing it, so that he could savour his fights, because no opponent after that fight gave him the thrill of battle. And even for the majority of the story, Kenpachi Limited stood atop, considered to be a threat by a god. In combat, Zaraki is unmatched. With his own sword style, Zaraki can adapt his attack patterns along with his ability to withstand his opponent's attacks while maintaining an offensive poise, which allows him to attack in situations where others would opt to defend. He is considered so much of a threat that the governing body of the Soul Society, the Central 46, forbids him from learning Zanjutsu or studying proper swordsmanship under Yamamoto in the fear that a fully polished Zaraki happens to go rogue. Zaraki Kenpachi contributes heavily to the war effort. He assists in keeping Gerard Valkyrie at bay after activating his Bankai, overpowering him before unfortunately succumbing to the strain of his newly untapped power, to which Yachiru states was only releasing a fraction of his strength. This goes back to the notion that you need 10 years to really master a Bankai, and it proves that. He also defeats the Stern Ritter Gremi, whose power is literally imagination, which was unironically the moment of which defines Zaraki Kenpachi's strength, as the validation comes into when Gremi imagines his own strength equal to Zaraki's, an action that resulted in his own death as his body couldn't handle the power on par with Zaraki's. Though side note, I will say that this is debatable on why Gremi's power backfired here. Ichibei Hoyotsube was selected due to his immense wisdom. Alive since its inception, Ichibei is the godfather of the Soul Society, and within him lies the entire history and its secrets. This level of knowledge grants Ichibei immense insight, allowing him to strategize and act from perhaps the most informed position of any combatant. Had it not been for the awakening of Yuachi's almighty power, Ichibei would have taken the victory. Unfortunately, time was against Ichibei, and unfortunately, he succumbed to his death. Kinda. Unfortunately, this wisdom contributes to Ichibei's undoing. His eternal tenure as Soul Society's protector means that Ichibei witnessed the original defeat of the Quincy 1,000 years ago, a result that leads him overconfidently to believe that history would in fact repeat itself. Ichibei does not account for Yuachi's ability to evolve, and as a result, suffers a crushing loss at the hands of the Almighty. Though, in fact, I wouldn't say that he didn't live up to his expectation. In fact, Yuachi made these cautions pre-Almighty ability, and he was the only Shinigami to put Yuachi on the ropes while Ichigo and Kenpachi struggled to even put a scratch on him in this state. But I think I'm going to hand over these next two to Tekken 101.
Now, Kisuke Urahara was selected as a special war power, well, simply for being Kisuke Urahara, I mean, come on. But it was because of his unpredictability. He was deemed the incalculable schemer by Asken Naklevar. Urahara doesn't enter the fray until he's prepared for situations in every scenario for every possible situation, A through Z and beyond. When Ichigo's Mugetsu failed to defeat Aizen, it was Urahara that sealed him for good, revealing his creation of a Kido spell tailor-made for the occasion, a precaution that effectively saved the entire world. During the war, Uehara's appearances are brief, but very impactful to the story as he completely outwits Asken Naklevar. After a one-on-one confrontation and at the brink of death and defeat, Uehara reveals his trump card, using his Bankai to create an opening in Asken's Giftbereich that allows Grimmjow to enter and deal a fatal blow. When a dying Asken announces that his ability will collapse and kill everyone present, we then see Neliel 2 Odishwonk, who reveals that this was within Uehara's foresight the entire time, stationing her on standby to aid in his escape in case such a turn of events. Sosuke Aizen was placed on the list because of his immense spiritual pressure. Aizen's spiritual pressure was ridiculous, even before fusing with the Hogyoku, exemplified by his negation of Soifon's Nageki Kasetsu two-hit certain death ability, simply overpowering her Riatsu with his own. In Aizen's own words, Shinigami battles are battles of Riatsu, so therefore whoever has the most wins. To even fuse with the Hogyoku in the first place, Aizen states that Riatsu at least double that of a normal captain is required. learned, further stating that he is in possession of more than this amount in just his base form alone. After fusing with the Hogyoku, Aizen's spiritual pressure increases to a level that even Muken, in the best restraints in the Soul Society created by the 12th Division, could not hope to seal his power, capable of only decreasing its area of effect. Aizen plays a key role in the final confrontation with Yuha. It's arguable that Aizen was able to affect Yuha very early on in the war during their first invasion into the Soul Society, with evidence to this by deceiving his own sense of time. Because of this pre-planning, even with Yuha bestowed godlike abilities upon himself, he was still affected by Aizen's power, and this debuff was not removed. This helps because his Kyoka Suigetsu's complete hypnosis deceives Yuha and gives Ichigo an opening to attack. The aftermath distracts Yuha and grants Uryu Ishida the opportunity to shoot him with the still silver arrowhead. As subjugation to an ability comes down to the ryatsu of one against that of another, the fact that Yuha succumbs to Kyoka Suigetsu while emerged with the Soul King demonstrates just how overwhelming Aizen's spiritual pressure is, so much so that Yuha tried to merge or absorb Aizen only to fail. Aizen's just too beast.
So with that being said, everyone, what did you guys think of the five war potentials? Did they live up to their expectations? Who do you think did? Who do you think didn't? What do you think could have been done better from these five? Who do you think should have been a war potential and who should have been considered? And did they truly ever live up to the hype? I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Anyway, of course, go check out Tekken's channel in the description down below. Do you want to see us collab again? Please let us know in the comment section down below. And if you guys could give this video a fat like, that would be amazing and I'd appreciate it. Of course, thank you to our sponsor again. And as always, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.